All right. What's up?
All right. What's going on? Welcome everyone to Spicy Boys DAOC podcast, episode 6, a very spicy Christmas podcast special. It's going to be a good one. I mean, as you can already tell, we got half the Spicy Boys here, right? Six total.
Yep.
So I'm just going to jump right in. Obviously, we know Enc, producer Enc. We know Cotton, myself. We know Pepper from, I guess he's over here, but from last episode. But I want to introduce the rest of the Spicy Boys we have on today. First, let's start in the top left corner. We got Dano Mike.
Dano.
What's up?
Flex for us, Dano. Been,
yeah.
Oh, God, look at that guy.
That was a weak flex. Like, that was there. Yeah, it's still pretty bad. He's from California. We'll let it go. And then moving over, we got our minstrel, Illusive.
Yo, what up?
What up? How's everyone doing?
Oh, well, we got one more guy.
Oh, hold I was on. Skipping him.
Hold on. Go ahead. Yeah, well. A lot of people would probably like us too. This guy is probably sad on you. I guarantee it. He rocking wings last week. One of my favorite people out there. Negative.
What up? Nice.
That was perfect.
The mute.
What's up, guys? All
right. I'm going to actually pass it back over to Enc today. Enc is just running to the show. We got some fun stuff lined up. We're going to be doing trivia. Yeah.
Today's going to be super casual. Podcast mode, but I have designed us a somewhat of an eventful evening. We're going to be going over some criteria that will expose how we think and feel about one another to a certain extent, and then get into some trivia, which should be pretty fun as well. But we're going to go ahead and start what I'm calling the preliminary round, and I have instructed all of y'all to get your DMs ready to give me the answers, and then we're going to go over those answers individually. But the first thing we're going to go over is we're going to go over a scenario, all right? That scenario is the following. During an AV8 fight, you personally have just been caught with a root. The enemy group is closing in on you. You get stunned, and then you see the tri-debuff take effect on your character. If you could pick one out of all of the Spicy Boys, who do you trust will react the most efficiently with heals and keep you alive? And you cannot vote for yourself. That is the only rule. You cannot vote for yourself. Once again, you've been rooted. The tri-D buff is coming at you. You're about to get smoked. Who is the one Spicy Boy you would trust to effectively keep you alive? You have 20 seconds.
And we need DMing those, this.
Yeah, you're DMing it to me.
All right. I had that typed before anyone said anything.
Oh shit. I'm worried about this one. I don't like this one.
I can't vote for myself, right?
This is my category.
All right.
No one's gonna vote for me.
The answers are in. We're gonna go in the order in which they were received. Negative came in first. His answer is...
Oh, hold on. We're doxing what people say.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. So this is anonymous? Oh, no.
It's anonymous until I decided for it not. Bishop is Negative's answer.
Wow, dude. That hurts.
I'm fucking choice, healing you anymore, choice. Boy.
Dano-mite came in second. His answer is Bishop. That's two.
Yep. I quit.
That's cold-blooded, bro.
I was going to say Bishop...
Cotton came in with his vote. He put in Pepper. That's one for Pepper, two for Bishop.
If you didn't vote for me, I would have been really hurt.
Pepper comes in with Cotton. That's 1-1 and two for Cotton, Pepper, and Bishop. And then Illusive comes in with Bishop solidifying.
Damn.
Vote number three.
It doesn't. Oh, fuck the original.
No, more heals for any of
it
you.
It doesn't even matter what I vote because Bishop comes in swinging. So Bishop has been awarded the most trusted Spicy Boy Healer Award for this year.
Yikes. Let me ask you, Enc, though. You just doxed everyone's answers. What? Mm-hmm. Yeah, who would you pick?
My vote was Pepper.
Fuck
Thank
me.
You.
I'm playing the Necro. So, all right, good luck, guys.
Cotton, if it was most trusted buffer, all you, all day. You're both.
It's fucked up. The amount of times I've saved negative is so much more than Bishop, and he goes with Bishop. That's just cold-blooded.
Yeah, they don't.
It wouldn't be spicy if we didn't.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true. Fair enough.
All right. Moving on to the next one.
dramatic.
That was our Trusted Healer Award. Next, we're going to do what we call the Versatility Award. All right. If all the Spicy Boys had access to each other's accounts, which one Spicy Boy would you feel confident in playing any role on any realm just in case someone could not log in and play?
And again, one's harder.
You can't vote for yourself. You've got 30 seconds.
I don't like this.
It's all about dividing people up and causing drama, boys. We've already pissed Cotton off. We're on a roll.
I'm really torn between two.
I'm people. Deleting the cleric.
You know that's what? Your highest rail, Mike.
Fuck you guys and don't smite.
Okay, let's go. All right, one more person. Enhance. One more person.
Gonna be on the melee train.
All right, the answers are in. All right, in which they were received. First, this time was Dano. Bishop is his answer. Negative coming in with Incella. That's me. Cotton coming in with Inc. That's me. That's so two for me, one for Bishop. Illusive coming in with Bishop. That's 2-2. And Pepper coming in with Incella. Oh, and I can't vote for myself. I would have voted for Bishop. Or no, I would have voted for Negative. I would have voted for Negative.
I was torn between
Dano and Cotton.
I was torn between you and
so that's 3-2-1.
Hold on, we're saying
likely you vote for Negative.
I just want to talk about this real quick.
Yeah, let's talk.
Any role out there, right?
Any role.
Why are you going to vote for possibly Negative? Negative can't play a hunter or a stealther
or anything
or a thane. Because I won't doesn't mean that
he voted for Negative.
Ever.
I voted for Negative so he can get the win.
Yeah. Well. Yeah. Sure. Absolutely. I actually pre-typed my votes out. I can screen cap it. But anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Uh huh.
I went with Incella just because I've never seen Negative heal. So I don't know.
I've never seen Negative heal too. He played
never
a fire.
I've seen him heal on the Mentalist. I'm
cracked.
Well, I mean, like a primary healer. Yeah, sure.
I think he healed one out on a cleric.
He has saved my bard with that mint numerous times in and out of like duos and eight bands.
Even in the eighth, he was healing his ass off on Mentalist.
There's a video of me calling for heals, and I think all three of y'all had to heal me to keep me alive.
Yeah.
All right, next. I think this one's going to be a pretty easy answer, but we're going to do it anyway. This is the Hype Man Award. whether we are mindlessly PvEing or dominating out in the new frontiers, who is the Spicy Boys Hype Man to boost morale and add to the vibes?
Sent already.
Yep. There they
all
are.
I think it's going to be unanimous.
Street. And then my vote was also Street. Street is the hype man. Better luck next year to anyone else who was hoping to win that award.
Seriously, though, we were talking about that earlier. Like, there's something when you have Street on MA where he has a role where he has to talk, he has to communicate. And he really is like it just changes the mood.
Oh yeah.
I'm not gonna lie. If I can vote for like a second, this one may be really surprising. I would actually say Negative, because there's sometimes Negative says just the perfect thing at the right moment where it's just like it flips the whole fucking fight. We're on our back feet, and then all of a sudden he's like, you know what? Let's fuck these guys up. And it's like, yeah, okay, yeah, let's fuck these guys up.
Negative and Street together. Negative and Street together when they get going and they're both in like good moods and shit. That's infectious. See,
that's where I was gonna go, is we can both say the wrong things too. So there's that.
So
part of it.
My one caveat is when Street and Negative are both in good moods, things are great. If there's anything at all that shifts the other direction, it can be relatively detrimental. But I think that affects everyone, you know, when we get frustrated and stuff. But yeah, Street, you are the hype man. He's in chat. Congratulations, Street.
Hopefully he was here for that one.
Let's go, Street.
I think he was.
See. Okay, here we go. So this is similar to versatility, but I want y'all to think about this outside of obvious reasons. I want y'all to think about this for any reason whatsoever. This is the Mr. Dependable Award, okay? Out of all the Spicy Boys, if you are forced to duo and you can only choose one duo partner for the entire season, for any reason, okay, for any reason, who would you choose? 30 seconds. Duo partner, you're forced to duo for the rest of the season. Who is it going to be? One more. All right, they're in. Dano came in flying with negative as his answer.
He's always there. He'll never let you down. He's always logged in.
Cotton with Pepper came in. Negative came in with Pepper. That's two for Pepper. Illusive came in with Cotton.
Ooh, hello.
And Pepper came in with Cotton. So we have three Pepper, two. Pepper, Cotton, and one negative. Okay.
What's your vote?
Negative. So that's a three-way tie.
It's a three-way tie. Let's go.
Yeah, I figured it would be a three-way tie with your answer. Of course I'm going to pick Cotton.
Yeah, me and Pepper, we're as always duo partners, and we always do the weird shit where it's like, hey bro, what if we try Nature Druid and your warden? Let's see what that fucking does.
That's why I picked Cotton, because
Negative didn't choose me because I abandoned him last season. That's just him getting back at me right there.
Nah, honestly, I was gonna choose Illusive, but his playtime's so bad, always moving.
Stuff, so. Yeah, catch me last year. I was on every
negative
day.
Just picks me because I'm the clerk that's on the most with him in the daytime. That's what he needs.
All right. Here's what we'll do. Street, who's the tiebreaker? You're in chat. If you had to pick any of those three people, whether it would be Cotton, Pepper, or Negative, who would be your duo partner to break the tiebreaker?
I know how he's going to go.
I think so too. If he's hopefully he's here.
Guy, this guy chose this guy. This guy chose Thurg. He is unpredictable. All right.
Yeah, unpredictable.
He is unpredictable. That's so true.
We'll see if he responds. Chose Thurg. I'm sure he'll
did
respond.
He even play as Thurg just this season
for 5 minutes.
The response is gonna be a taxi.
Negative is the winner. Negative is Mr. Dependable, and that's right.
I mean that checks out.
He's always on. Always seriously. On.
I should not have been in that running, honestly. I appreciate no, I mean, if Pepper for what it is.
If it's playtime, like if
it's not talking about
weighing playtime in more, yeah, I'm picking negative. But yeah. Like
I wasn't going off playtime. I was going off like the fun we could have, you know what I mean?
Yeah, like just what you said. Yeah. Like obviously Cotton's my best friend, so that's a huge part. But also like we'll do weird shit, you know. If, like we like to try stuff out.
If I'm voting on fun, it's Cotton because me and Cotton literally made animists acted like idiots for like 2 hours, and it was a blast. Absolute blast. And I don't think we did anything.
Y'all did a, what, Wizard and Friar or some maybe shit at Herb Tower?
Wizard and Cleric. We were, I actually have a video on that. We were hella successful.
It's not very good, but we did fine.
We were cashing in, though. We were cashing
in. We were. It's not a good duo, though.
It's not good. No speed. Literally hardly any CC coming out. If they get on us, I hope her barbs works, but...
All right, we got one more. The spiciest boy. All right, the spiciest boy. Whether it's an annoyance-induced rage, boiling frustration, sitting on top of the same idiot that adds on every fright, or you're just being a very spicy boy for the day, who amongst the ranks earns the title of the spiciest boy? We're talking yelling, raging, calling people out, whatever it may be, however you want to perceive it. Who is the spiciest boy? I've got three answers in.
See, spicy to me
that's so hard,
is kind
dude.
Of a compliment. Yeah.
It
know?
Is, yeah. I mean, I would say calling each other out is healthy. Whether it's fully justified or not, it still brings us closer together, in my opinion.
Dude, I can't pick. I can't vote on this. I'm struggling here.
You got 20 seconds. You got to put in an answer. I've got 5 from Cotton. I don't know why he quit it's typing.
Hard. It's hard. In a different way.
The whole team.
All right. Dano came in first with Street as the spiciest boy. Illusive came in with Street as the spiciest boy. Negative put Taxi.
Oh, God. That makes sense. I mean.
Cotton put Cody, Mac, fuck, I don't know. Okay, go Pepper. Pepper for the whole team.
He said Cody, though.
I'm going to go with Cody, the first one. And then Pepper put in negative. So Cody and Street are tied 2-2. Moxie, are you there?
Yeah.
Okay, Moxie, you grouped with us last night, and there was a lot of yelling and chaos.
No.
Who is the spiciest boy?
I said negative.
You said negative. Okay.
Yeah, she typed it.
Did that make the tie worse?
I think it made it worse.
I think it's three ways. It's three ways. Worse.
Street still there.
Look, have Street. Have Street.
Street said between Ink and Neg, all things considered, hard question, to be honest.
It's a hard question.
Well, yeah.
That is a tough one. But he did say negative.
I will say, on two sides of the spectrum, Mac for me and Pepper for me, because Pepper, he's spicy in a way where, like, he's HR, you know? you fuck up in a moral way. Pepper is the number one person that he's going to tell you. You know, you reject a PR in the middle of a fight because you think it's over, and we end up winning. Pepper will tell you, you go suck a dick. Dude.
Sounds like you come from experience.
That may have happened.
Well, it happened.
Oh,
we may be a spicy boy less. So,
well, I think we'll give it to... that's tough.
I was going to give it to negative, too.
You were? Okay.
Yeah, I was going to say negative, but...
So negative...
I feel like negative's... He's real calm sometimes. So
it could be either one on the
streets, just like riled up no matter what.
It's true.
It's
kind of my face. I want him dead.
Even when negative's riled up, like he just like it's just his delivery that sounds
Street,
calm.
Street
He's
says,
not calm.
Street says, Ink takes a lot of initiative to get us all online in gaming. Because of that, I go Ink. So that drops a negative vote. But then Elusive said he would go for negative. So I think we're going to go with
a tie. Choice.
I think Cotton's answer is the best.
I think we're going to go with Cotton's answer, the whole team. Undecided.
No, I don't like it. I take it back.
The spiciest boy.
Have an award.
The spiciest boy. What I'll do is...
make a vote.
Well, what I'll do is I will reach out to all the other members who aren't here. And next podcast episode, we will reveal the spiciest boy. All right.
There you go.
So
we'll struggle with it.
A little suspense. All right. Let's get into our trivia game. So, gentlemen, we're going to be playing 3 rounds of trivia, 3 different categories that are all pertaining to DAOC. Okay. Round 1 questions, there will be 4. Each question in round 1 is going to be worth 2 points. And then at the end of each round, there's going to be a dare question where you will dare all of your points for a chance to double them. Okay. Mm. But if you get it wrong, you lose the points that you've earned in that round. And then the last round, you'll have a chance to double all of your points or lose all of them. Okay. You follow? I'll explain it more as we get to them. But, you will need something to write with and a notepad to do a little math on one question in round 3, okay? It's going to be the last round.
Can I use a calculator? I know you said no Google, but can I use a calculator?
No. You got to write it out.
I got to go get a pen.
I think I did, but no one listened to me, so it's okay.
Nobody listened.
Yeah, it's okay.
Bro, I don't have a fucking piece of paper anywhere.
Yeah, no, I don't keep paper in my house. It's...
He's an environmentalist.
That sounds like some Hib shit, dude. I'm not with that.
You don't have that ficus paper, dude?
You don't got no ficus, dude?
They pass them out at Half all the time, dude. Y'all give a shout out to Moxie, who is here with us.
Oh, yeah.
She is going to be our scorekeeper. Hello, Moxie.
Hello. Waving aggressively.
She's the spicy girl. Holy shit.
All right. I got a pin.
Negative just went into his computer.
Bro, that was crazy.
Yeah. You're like, well, I haven't written with one of these in forever, dude.
I legitimately don't have a piece of paper.
Palm of your hand.
Rip open that pizza box. Use the inside of it.
Yeah, I got a paper towel. I got you.
Let's go. Well, you might be able to do the math in your head. Best of luck. But that's not till the last round. All right. Round one. The three realms. All right. Let me get my timer out because these are timed. You are submitting your answers via DM. Okay.
Don't read chat because let the people play too.
Let the people play, but don't read chat. Let's all keep this fair.
As he looks at
you. I minimize the chat. Don't worry.
The timer. I'm going to repeat the question twice. The timer will start when I'm done reading the question for the second time. All right. Are we ready?
Mm-hmm.
All right. 30 seconds to answer question one. Which of the three realms has the most classes that can cast a nearsight spell? Which of the three realms has the most classes that can cast a nearsight spell? 30 seconds.
I definitely can't Google these answers.
I don't know what the answer is.
15 seconds.
The time puts too much pressure on me. I can't respond under this.
Kind 10 of... seconds. All right. Answers are in. We'll stop there. The answer is Hibernia.
That's right. I knew it. I knew it the whole
Hibernia
time.
Hibernia has the obvious Eld and Mentalist, but they also have the Banshee now. With that focal nearsight. It is still technically a nearsight. So, Dano, incorrect. Negative is correct. Illusive is incorrect. Cotton is correct. And Pepper is correct. So, Cotton, Negative, and Pepper were all correct and awarded 2 points. Moxie, if you need me to repeat any of these things at any point in time, just let me know, okay?
I got you, bud.
Thank you. All right, question number two. You will also have 30 seconds. Which of the three realms has the most classes that can cast an AoE or PBAoE damage over time spell? Which of the three realms has the most classes that can cast an AoE or PBAoE damage over time spell?
Dots.
Easy. Easy.
Is it?
Mm-hmm. You just got to play the game, baby.
Four people in 15 seconds.
I honestly have no idea.
All right. Answers are in. Good job. Y'all are getting them in quick. The answer is Albion.
Mm-hmm.
That is the Wizard Cabalist and the PBOE Necromancer dot.
My personal favorite.
Cotton is correct with Alb. Illusive is incorrect. Negative is correct. Dano is incorrect. And Pepper is incorrect. So Illusive and Negative are correct that round. Good job, gentlemen.
What do you guys think?
I'm not correct.
I'm just wondering.
Cotton and Negative were correct that round.
Illusive was wrong. No, sorry. I was wrong. Yeah, I'm sorry. Yeah. Good job, Moxie. You're paying attention. I'm not. Beautiful. Yep. All right. Question three. Which of the three realms has the most classes that can cast an AoE mez? Which of the three realms has the most classes that can cast an AoE mez? 30 seconds.
Including PBOE?
Cast an AoE mez. Specifically, an AoE mez.
I mean, point blank, AoE.
Specifically, AoE. You have 15 seconds.
The time makes me incapable of answering these well.
2 seconds.
I don't think I'm right.
Woo, Negative barely got in there.
I don't think I'm right.
The answer is Albion.
Woo!
Is it?
Sorcerer, Thurgist, and the Minstrel can all cast.
Oh, the Minstrel. That's who I forgot. Yeah. Minstrel.
Illusive is correct. Dano-mite is correct. Cotton is correct.
Let's go, Dan.
Pepper's not.
Pepper and negative are incorrect. So again, correct were Cotton, Dano, and Illusive.
You guys went with Hib, didn't you?
Yeah, I just forgot about the Minstrel. I was thinking Light Eld, Bard, but I couldn't think of the third one on either.
Minstrel's tough. All right. Are we at the dare question yet? Nope, we are not. Here we go. All right, this is another standard 2-point question, 30 seconds to answer. Which of the three realms has the most classes that can cast a DMez spell? Which of the three realms has the most classes that can cast a DMez spell? 30 seconds.
Wait, this is a trick question.
15 seconds.
Is it?
Yeah, because what about DMez on your pet? That counts as a DMez spell.
Nah, this is strictly.
Yeah.
Bolster's not a DMez either. This is casting a DMez spell.
I mean, I cast on a player. On a necromancer.
On a player. On a player. Yeah.
Okay.
The answer.
Can you get 30 more seconds?
The answer. Can I change my answer?
The answer is Hibernia.
Of course. Because of the Banshee, but we're not counting bolsters.
God, I forgot about the Banshee.
Well, I think each realm has a bolster.
Each realm has a bolster. Yeah, so it would all still be the same.
And you got pet DMezes too.
We should all got that right. We were gonna be hit. Remember, we were talking about the Banshee.
It's
I suck at trivia.
So Dan, it's Hibernia with the Bard Mint and the Banshee. So Dano was correct, Cotton was correct, and Illusive was correct. Those three were correct. All right, Moxie, could you give us a tally of everyone's total score so far, please?
We have Cotton with 8, Pepper with 2, Negative with 4, Dano with 4, Elusive with 4. Cotton in the lead by double.
Big old nerd.
I suck.
All right, so remember those current scores, gentlemen, because if you decide to answer this next question, what happens is if you get it correct, you will double your current score or lose the points that you've earned thus far, making you 0 for round 1. Does that make sense?
Yep.
Yeah.
All right. This is our what we're calling a double down dare question.
Math.
You're going to have 1 minute to answer this question. It's not the math one. And this one's pretty just think, okay? Here we go. When considering both classic
Wait, I have a question before you start.
Uh-huh.
When do we decide if we're doubling down or not?
You either answer or you don't answer. If you don't answer, if you answer, you're doubling down. If you don't answer, you're playing it safe and keeping your points.
Gotcha.
1 minute to answer. Here we go. When considering both classic and Shrouded Isles zones, which of the three realms has the most dungeons due to a technicality? When considering both classic and Shrouded Isles zones, which of the three realms has the most dungeons due to a technicality? 1 minute, beginning now.
Due to a technicality? What?
It's got to be...
Don't say weird. Anything. Yeah.
No fucking clue.
You got a whole 35 more seconds. You don't have to answer. It's only if you can think of it and know it. It's a dare question.
You risk it? I think I know.
Well, I'm just going to risk it.
We'll let it go.
Complete guess.
Elusive has got his answer dialed in. Gentlemen, you have 15 seconds. Pepper has answered.
You know how many times I've been in a dungeon?
I only got 2 points. I might as well fucking risk it.
You're not counting five instances, right?
Shrouded Isles and classic.
Oh, that's right. My bad.
All right, time's up. The answer. Let me look at these answers real quick. Wow. the answer is Albion.
I knew it.
I knew it too. I should have said it.
Can I guess the technicality? Can I
go ahead?
Is it Avalon City?
Because
you zone in. It's its own.
Well, you zone area. In. Okay, so when you
it has a dungeon within it.
You go. Crystal Caves is a dungeon. Yeah,
it has a dungeon
within
a dungeon.
Oh, shit, it isn't.
So when you look at all the Shrouded Isles dungeons, because that's where they misalign. Albion has one extra because of the technicality. That is a dungeon within a dungeon.
And that's where Zanzikar is, right?
Correct. The Crystal Caves is where Zanzikar is.
Yeah, I should have done
it. So how many of us have actually been in there?
So
I've never been in there.
So Moxie, Illusive, and Pepper both answered incorrectly, so they go down to zero.
I only had two, so I don't know why you shouldn't have risked it.
Me?
Yeah. I was dead taker. Last anyways.
I'm a risk taker. Well, now we're tied. Let's go.
All right. The next round questions will go ahead.
Pepper and Illusive lost their points. Pepper got double.
No. They lost their points, so they're zero.
No one else answered it.
Cotton didn't answer correctly. He didn't put in an answer. He guessed after the fact.
Oh, okay.
Can I just intersect real quick with two things?
Go ahead.
One, I'm AFK out on the docks in EV and someone just killed me. That was rude. Two, I did just happen to look at chat and Nefkate said, Cotton, why did he take away my Purge 1? I'm sorry.
Oh, that was him.
That was him. And that put us into like CSI mode. The whole guild was in Discord trying to figure out how the hell that worked.
There's no way we die there. Or you die.
All right. Gentlemen, we are going to continue on with round two. Before we do so, Moxie, just for full clarification, what are our total scores after the conclusion of round one?
Cotton is 8, Pepper 0, Negative 4, Dano 4, Illusive 0.
All right.
Let's go.
Still anybody's game. We're moving on to round two. This is going to be Negative's favorite category, the Trials of Atlantis.
I'm in trouble here.
All right, question one.
I'm definitely in trouble.
These are not easy. Okay, these are not easy.
These are not easy.
It's too bad Zoo. Too bad Zoo's not here. He would probably know all of these. I knew most of them except one. But good luck, gentlemen. Round two, question one. 30 seconds to answer. Which zone of Atlantis would you find the Golden Spear artifact encounter? Just the name of the zone. So you should be able, to at least guess. You should know some of the zone names. Come on. And it don't have to. Like there's Volcanus, Eris, Boreal, Nodos, Meso. Yeah, those zones. Like what is the official
zone? I don't even know those zones.
I don't even know there's a zone. I don't even know that's a zone I just typed.
Oh man, we got to
work on this. What artifact was it?
Golden Spear. You have 15 seconds.
Hey chat, where's the golden spear? Go.
Lifeline.
Waiting on one more person. Negative put in an answer.
No.
I figured out when running around with Zoom that I don't remember any of the artifact encounters at all.
And he knew where every port was and everything.
The answer is Stygia or Stygia, however you wish to pronounce it.
And fuck, I did the wrong one.
I do remember that now that you said it.
The only person to get that correct is Pepper. Pepper with the correct answer. Very nice.
Hey, good guess.
Staff of God.
That's only because I was running around seeing what I could kill by myself.
What
up
was
there
the artifact?
I saw it on the map.
The Golden Spear.
Oh my God! I thought he did Staff of God. I was probably wrong with that too, but I was thinking of Staff of God.
All right. So Pepper comes in with a good start to round two. We're moving on to question two. What is the exact name of the dungeon where players complete the majority of Master Level 7? Just the name of the dungeon. Master Level 7. What is the exact name of the dungeon where players complete the majority of Master Level 7? 30 seconds.
What's sad is my guild ran that.
I don't even know what zone that is, dude.
Hold on. I got my TOA guide here somewhere.
Just... 15 seconds.
Oh, shit. That guy is purple. Oh, shit. He's actually fighting me.
I don't even have a... I don't even have to guess.
2 seconds. And time. Oh, you got it then. I'll give it to you. All right. Yeah. The answer is Deep Volcanus. It's called Deep Volcanus.
I don't think or,
I got a fuck you, no clue, Master Level 7 Dungeon, Blatherskite, and question mark. So 0 points across the board. I can't believe y'all didn't know what Deep Volcanus
was. Technically, I was right.
I don't think I ever went there. I'm going to be honest.
That's fine. That's fine. Y'all are definitely not going to get this one correct. Then let's get it over with as painlessly as possible. In 30 seconds, what is the exact name of, I'm sorry, what is the name of the boss fought during Master Level 5.10? Master Level 5's final boss. What is his name?
Oh.
30 seconds.
I think I remember where that one is.
Master Level 5.10, the final boss. What is his name?
Damn it.
15 seconds.
Fuck.
Wait, are you Googling?
No. No, I actually remember that one.
Uh-huh.
Two seconds.
Hurry, what was it?
The answer,
I don't know if I'm right or not.
Is God. The answer is Ammut. A-M-M-U-T.
Fuck.
Negative gets it correct. Dynamite came close with John Denver. And Pepper's not even in the right zone. So Negative gets that one correct.
Was that I actually close? Remember that one.
Wait, where is that mod?
So Master Level 5 is the one Master Level outside of 7 where it's like all group instances inside of a dungeon. And that dungeon is in the Land of Autumn, past Master Level 4.
Yeah, that's kind of sticky. Yeah, it's same shit.
Yeah. All right. Question 4, 30 seconds. Now this is where I'm going to get some of y'all. Spelled correctly, what is the name of the mob that drops the Cloud Song artifact? You stole my fucking Cloud Song. Spelled correctly, what is the name of the mob that drops the Cloud Song artifact? 30 seconds. I will give you half credit if the spelling is incorrect. All right. Good job. Answers are in. Dynamite is wrong. Negative linked me the You Stole My Fucking Cloud Song. Cotton is insisting on Babel Clappershite again.
Babel, no.
Illusive guest Ikonos. And Pepper said, I hate this round.
It's a pretty sad round,
we're
guys.
We're PvPers, man.
We don't do this shit. I don't.
The answer is Eramai or Eramai. E-R-A-M-A-I.
Never heard of that mob in my life.
So nobody.
I did my MLs, my TOA shit back on live, is I would just farm BPs to buy it in a way that I didn't need to do it.
But that wasn't there initially.
It wasn't, yeah, it which wasn't. Is why I never fucking had TOA shit.
All right. This yeah, one. All right, so we have a double down dare to do for round two. Now this could work out.
Double down 0 points.
Well, this could work out. This could work out in some of y'all's favor. If you haven't gotten any points this round, you can still risk the points of this round to double your entire score. So for those of you who got 4 points in round one and didn't get any in this round, you can still double up if you get this right. You're not going to, but I figured I'd still give you the opportunity.
If we're at zero, we can go for it and...
Go for it, and there's no penalty.
Cool.
Zero this round. Right. Yeah, because the round two double down dare is where you're risking the points of this round for a chance to double your whole score. All right?
Gotcha. Okay, I like it.
All right. Name all the bosses found in Celestius, the Master Level 10 dungeon. Name all of the bosses found in Celestius. 30 seconds. It's one zone.
These questions.
That's what I did. I wrote them.
You knew we were gonna fuck up on this this round two.
I knew all of these. Y'all just suck at the game. I'm sorry.
Realize most of us were gone for like 15 years and came back just to play the server.
So yeah. was I.
And you remember this shit? There's no way.
5 seconds. And done. All right. The answers are Sagittarius, Scorpius, Centaurus, Leo, and Draco.
Malfoy?
You forgot one for sure. Yeah.
Cotton put Aquarius. Illusive, no. Pepper goes, I only remember Hingle McCringleberry. And Negative said no shot.
I remember Hingle.
Yeah, Hingle McCringleberry was definitely in.
Are you sure? This guy doesn't know.
All right, so that round, nothing happened. Scores are the same. Jesus Christ. Let's move on to the final round.
Terrible.
Good Lord.
Let's get some PvP questions.
All right. This round, everyone should know. Hopefully. Round three is templating.
I don't know templating.
Templating. Half of us were doing this just before the podcast started. All right. These answers are short answers only. And they are going to be worth, what do we got?
6 points.
6 points apiece.
Oh, shit, I'm back in it. Let's go. Damn,
six points apiece. 30 seconds. Question one. What is the full name of the jewel that would be spellcrafted in order to achieve 7% crush resistance?
Okay. Bro, okay.
7%.
You're our only S-er.
Crush resistance. 7% crush resistance. What's the name of that jewel? 20 seconds.
I'll just go fuck myself.
It doesn't hurt. It doesn't hurt to guess on this one. Y'all know the names of the jewels? Come on.
I literally do not. I've never spellcrafted in my life.
Man.
I've never made a single one of those gems.
10 seconds.
Oh, wait.
5 seconds.
Right. I think I'm wrong, though.
All right. Answers are in.
That's matter. Fuck, I am wrong.
The answer is the imperfect fiery shielding jewel.
Pretty sure nope. It's crush resistor.
No one got it right. Jesus Christ.
We don't PvE. Think we craft? Come on.
We are hurting Moxie's feelings right now.
It's okay, guys. I'm here.
Moxie, make a category for yourself. I guarantee you could come back and win this whole thing.
100%. No, I'm not participating.
All right. Get your pencils, pens, and paper out. Here's the math question. You're going to have 4 minutes to do this math. At least try, please. At least try. Okay?
Okay.
Here we go. Ricky the Reaver is realm rank 5 and has just finished his new template, but needs to know what his block rate is when fully buffed. Knowing what his block rate will determine how much mastery of blocking he needs to train in order to reach capacity. If Ricky has 205 dex after putting on his template and he is spec'd 42 shield and has the cap plus 11 to his shield skill, what is his block rate when fully cap buffed? Do not include Mithrians. Once again, Go ahead, Cotton.
I just want to say you guys know this game so much more than I do.
Ricky the Reaver is realm rank 5 and has just finished his template, but needs to know what his block rate is. Okay, he has 205 dex and in his template, and he is spec'd 42 shield with plus 11 to shield skill. What is his block rate when he is fully buffed with cat buffs? Do not include Mithrians. 4 minutes beginning now. Two of y'all should know this, at least. Our Christmas music, by the way, is bumping in the background. Negative's answer is in.
Repeat it one more time.
No problem. Ricky the Reaver has 205 decks after putting on his template, and he is spec'd 42 shield and has the cap plus 11 shield in his template. He is also realm rank 5. What is his block rate when he is fully cap buffed? Do not include Mithrians. So 205 decks, realm rank 5, 42 plus 11 shield, all in his template, and he's fully buffed. What is his block rate? You have 3 minutes.
Apparently, you should ask way easier questions for us.
Yeah, I just want to say this question has nothing to do with a template.
Look at my logic.
This is knowing like just math of the deck.
Look at my logic, Zilla.
Hold on, I haven't looked yet. I can't even retype that answer, or not retype. Is it?
I'm on a fucking napkin, bro.
Yeah, I see. I see it. We're good. We're good.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, we're good.
That's pretty close.
We have 4 answers in out of 5, I think, or 6, or 5, 5. You got a whole minute and 45 seconds left for anyone else who wants to put in an answer. Okay, that's everyone. All right. Let me go ahead and look at these.
That's not good.
Only one person got it correct, and that was Illusive.
Did he?
Yeah. The complete answer.
Guess
on a guess,
bro. Okay. Look at this is what I put. I was like, oh, that's the dex, and I was like, fuck it, I'm a guess.
So it's 205 plus 155. That's the buffs, and the stats of the template. That equals 360. You multiply that by 2. That equals 720. Then, if you know your calculation, you take that 720, subtract 100, and divide it by 40, and that gives you 15.5%. And then you add in the fact that he's 42 plus 11 shield. You can't surpass 50. That's 25 plus the base 5, 30 plus the 15 is 45.5%. You can round that up to 46 to be specifically correct. But Illusive got it with 45. That's close enough. Illusive is going
Let's
to
go
take,
back on the board.
How would I take ever the points know there. This stat?
If you've ever put any template together and have calculated your block, parry, or evade rate, that's how you do it.
I don't think in the question you asked for the specific number. You just said, what's the block rate?
Like and percentage.
The percentage. Technically. What, yeah. Oh, well, hold on. Let me read Cotton's answer for a technicality.
Is that pretty good?
At least 7.
Yeah, that's good.
At least 7.
Yeah,
he's not wrong.
Judges, they're not going to count that.
Damn bastards! Yeah,
they're hibs.
Yeah, that makes sense. Oh, Automus is raided.
Automus with a party of 6. Thank you so much for the raid. We appreciate it. Welcome everybody here. We are finishing up a round of trivia. It's kind of disappointing. All right, question 3. You're going to have 1 minute to answer this. Just think about it. Found in many templates, this item's origin is not presently accessible on Eden. However, it is in the game. It has 2 stat caps and 5 TOA bonus stats. What item is it? Once again, 1 minute to answer. Found in many templates, this item's origin is not presently accessible on Eden. However, it is in the game. It has 2 stat caps and 5 TOA bonus stats. You have 1 minute. And I will say, I use this item in many of our templates that I make for ourselves. Moxie says, for the love of God, please get this right.
I don't know.
two stat caps and five TOA bonuses on it, on one item. 20 seconds. Again, this one particular, there's no, it does not hurt to guess. Time. All right. The answer is the Construct Forge Ring.
Oh, shit. Yeah.
Its origin is Labby, yep. So you can't go to Labby.
Yep. Damn it.
I don't.
Yeah. I do remember that.
I should have answered that one, right? That's
Cotton was close with the Thong of Justice, but.
Thong of Justice.
Nobody getting it correct. God dang. That's tough.
There's no way you thought we'd get any of these right.
Construct Forgering? Yeah. I use that in like every template.
Who didn't just memorize the stats though? Like
Moxie, yeah, did you know that one?
Not me, that's for damn sure.
Moxie, did you know that one?
I did know that one.
Good, good. Yeah, all right. Question four. All right. This one's tough. Okay, here we go. I'm going to try to... Let me explain this one to the rest of my ability. Yeah, go ahead.
This one's tough?
Yeah, this one's tough. Oh, others, got it. Others were easy.
Everybody, this one's tough.
All right.
Let's go ahead and give everyone 0 points. Or...
All right, think about this. This is a good Savage and Zerker question. All right, Pepper, you should get this. Okay?
I've been Savage for 2 weeks, man. I'll try my best. Dana, come on.
Dana, you got this.
Think about this, guys. This one's... Just think about it, okay? What combination of character attributes, TOA stats, and item classifications or stats. Classifications is a better word. So again, what combination of character attributes, TOA stats, and item classifications would a two-handed troll savage need to cap his damage in one hit with one swing? So one hit, one swing. What combination of character attributes, TOA stats, and item classifications? And if you list them out, and whoever gets the closest is going to get the credit for the score. Is how I'll judge it. One swing. I'm going to give you a minute. And it's a list of answers, but that list is pretty straightforward if you just think about everything that affects one swing on a two-handed troll savage. One swing max damage. Seconds. Five. All right, good. Everyone's in. All right, the answer, number one, cap strength, obviously.
Boom.
Okay. Style damage, melee damage, and the only other thing that would affect one swing is a 6.0 weapon speed.
Nope.
What about if he has damage add?
Read my answer.
Max strength, melee damage, style damage, a DD proc.
I damage, said proc as well.
Damage add, both blah, 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 blah. All right, hold on. Let me check something real quick. I got to check the question.
I also said tenacity and confidence.
You said he swings one time. One time he swings what does the most damage.
Yeah, so if y'all answered extra stuff, that's fine. But I was looking for character attributes. So that's your stat. TOA stats. And then an item classification. So it's just those three things.
I forgot about the item classification. But
so the swing. What I'm looking for is cap strength, style damage, melee damage, and then a 6.0. The rest of that stuff's buff, so if you added that, that's fine. Let me go over it real quick and just make sure we got...
I think your answer's wrong.
It's not, though.
Because if you have lower quickness, you hit harder.
Yep.
Right. That's why
it's one swing. It doesn't matter.
It's one swing.
Yeah, but exactly. But if you have higher quickness,
lower quickness,
but you didn't add that to the thing.
It's weapon speed. Only weapon speed affects damage for one swing.
No, the faster you swing, the less damage you do.
Yeah.
One swing.
Less tested.
If you have 200 quickness versus 250,
if you have no quickness, you will hit harder.
I was on the fence about the quickness.
You hit harder the less quickness you have. So
if you don't, that was a myth. If you do or don't have it, it don't matter.
It says it in the tooltip.
Okay, hold on.
In the loading screen.
I'm going to start muting people. All right, elusive is correct. Negative is correct.
I don't melee.
Cotton put tenacity and confidence.
Not wrong.
It plays into it. Tell me I'm wrong.
I forgot the weapon classification part. I was just thinking stats.
Wait, did you even say the answer to that part?
6.0. It's a 6.0 weapon speed. I'll take strength and quick, the differentials. Style damage, melee damage. But if you only had strength, melee, style damage, and then the weapon is what I was looking for. So elusive is correct. Negative is correct. Yeah, so just those two.
Correct.
Just those two. Everyone else was in the ballpark and very, very close, but yeah. All right.
Fucking item classification, man. Come on.
What is the total scores, Moxie?
Cotton with 8, Pepper with 4, Negative with 14, Dano with 4, Illusive with 12.
Oh shit, I forgot. I got one TOA question. Forgot about that.
So negative is up by 2 negative. Points.
I'd be winning if I didn't risk it all.
Nope, I didn't risk it.
All right, so that's all the questions I have. So negative wins.
Therefore.
That was final question?
That was the final question.
Oh, yeah.
Fuck you, negative.
So negative.
Basically, we don't know shit about this game. Good job.
You know how to kill people, though, sometimes.
All right. So we've been going for an hour. Let's shift to a final round table here. Let's get to know everyone real quick. For those of you who haven't actually been on the podcast and got to talk about yourself and so on, we'll start with negative. Negative, your answer may not be as predictable as everyone else, but if you had to pick one realm for the rest of your DAOC career, what realm would it be?
Midgard.
Midgard. No. All right.
Do that.
And
12 RM, love it.
And then
it's my home and native land.
And if you had to pick one role or one class, you can classify it as either one. Either pick a class or a role specifically that you would play forever in Midgard. Which role would that be?
I knew you were going to ask about this question. And I can't say Warlock because it's not needed yet. So.
Man.
I think RCRM, man, was always my jam.
Okay.
Kind of enjoyed that. Kind of saw a little bit of that today on the Wizard. Had a lot of fun. Haven't done that in a long time. So.
Yeah, I was about to say, so how are you enjoying the Wizard so far? That you started today.
I love it.
It's a lot of fun.
I love not having to overthink things in the middle of stuff. It's just like, okay, let's kill whatever's next to me, right?
Yeah. The runs today, especially early on in our small man, you could just see the fun in that class, and it was. I'm excited to kind of keep doing it and getting better at it as a whole, and maybe
I'm blind, but yeah. Still seeing things, spots and stuff.
Maybe our minstrel will log in at some point in time, and you know it'll be really enjoyable.
Yeah, it'd be great.
It'd be a good time.
A little sauce.
Yeah.
Dano, one realm for the rest of your DAOC career. Which one is it, brother?
Midgard, 100%.
What class? What role?
Berserker.
Berserker.
Duh.
Even though everyone bashes the Zerker.
A little tear for them in season 2. They're bad. It's just there's something a little better. That's all.
Absolutely. And how are you enjoying ARMS so far, playing the ARMSman?
It's a different mindset. Heavy's definitely different. It's more like you're playing a game of chess. against my own team and their team, and I have to like, it's very difficult trying to look at what I'm doing in the front, and I'm usually just listening to what you guys are saying, but trying to look back and see what's going on, or if I'm too far, or what I need to do next, or someone needs a bolster. But
I'll tell you if you're too far, it's a slower game.
It's a slower, more methodical gameplay, but it's still very fun.
I think you kill it up front. You have, just like everyone else, you know, those bonehead moments, which have always been entertaining. Like, they've never been like out of frustration when they have. Like, what was it the other day? We were up in Hadrian's and we were hitting that mid group, and Dano just runs in like in the full middle send. Of all of them, full send.
So, I saw a fat mez. You got every single one of them. And the AUG healer perched, so I was on him quickly. And then another eight man came in, and you guys pushed. And at that point, they were all out, Demez, bolster, and they were all on top of me. There's nothing I could do.
It was so funny. So funny. But yeah, seeing you ping pong or pinball through all the targets and slamming them and interrupting stuff, like, we definitely see what you're doing. And I don't think there's anyone better who could be up there playing that class. So I think it's awesome.
Yeah, it's fun. It's not quite the adrenaline rush of Berserker running in, rah! But it's fun.
All right. What about Illusive? One realm for the rest of your DAOC career. Which realm is it going to be?
Very curious about Illusive.
Midgard.
I am too.
Midgard.
No, I knew.
And what class or role?
This one I don't know.
Yeah. I know this one. I know
it. Negative knows. Probably Stealther.
Wow.
Yep. Wow. I did know it. Yep.
We got a kicker now? Or?
So a shitter. Okay. Gotcha.
This was honor.
Man, it was not nice honor. Playing with you.
I'm an assassin, okay? Okay. Have some balls. I got to get in there and fight.
Wow. Okay. An assassin. So
second answer, though, if you had a second answer.
Probably like a RM or SM. Okay. I mean, RM on live.
I thought it was RM when we first talked. I thought it was RM.
Yeah, RM is what I came from on live, but I made an SM on Eden, so it's a toss-up. I really like RM, though, because it just, like, blows shit up.
I love how there is a pretty comical divide in our guild. We have Cotton, Pepper, and Street, who all bleed Albion. They bleed red. And they play their preferred classes for the most part, you know? You got these boys on clerics and stuff. And then, you know, Street said Thurg, but, you know, he's playing MA, caster, whatever you want to call it. And he's on Alb. He likes Alb. But these guys are playing Alb, but they prefer Midgard. I just think that's funny. And mine's Hib. Like, my answer's Hib, without a doubt. And it's Bard. So I'll probably be the only Hib preference. But
I've never even played Alb in my life. This is the first time I've ever even playing Alb.
Well, see,
I remember you saying that when you were leveling your armor.
Yeah. Yeah.
The only Alb experience I had was on Mordred on my Zerk, because everyone leveled and fought in Alb. Okay. That was it.
Yeah.
Because it's a better realm, baby. Everyone just wants to be.
There's no raids early on, and everyone's just killing each other.
Illusive, how are you enjoying Minstrel?
It's fun. I like the just like pesteriness of it. I can just like get in, get out. I can like fall back and help Demez. I can get in there, stun. I can stick on a target. Me and Dan, I always see me and Dan like just like splitting targets like without saying shit to each other. It's pretty fun. I like it.
What? I know this wasn't when you were on your armsman, but one thing I loved you and Dan being up front while we were in the BGs together, because, and also when we're playing normally, but there's in the video I posted, there's one time we came over the hill, we mezzed like two groups of Hibs, and Dan was in this pile with his pullout, and you were in this pile with your pullout, and you guys were just wrecking everyone as we were just like picking them apart, and it was just beautiful. I love you guys up front. You guys are killing it.
Yeah, it's fun. I just like the insta rups. Like, I don't have to be near a target to just like throw a rupt on him real quick and then switch back. I keep meleeing the target I'm on. And then my pet, that's another aspect. Like, that's like a whole nother me over there just hitting somebody for no reason.
Did you say you ever played Minstrel before?
Nah.
So the fact that you can play the way you do and you rarely ever overextend, you can always get back. That's like super impressive first time for sure.
I can't think of any specific times where we've had that problem.
It's me that dies, not him. So
I remember when it was no Dano, I was out there like I had to be in it to but yeah, I you have to. Died a lot.
Yep. That was just a few nights ago. Like, yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
You can definitely tell when the both of you aren't there. Like that's
it hurts that's so cool. A lot.
Like it hurts when the Mitchell's not there. It hurts when we don't have Dano. Like
so something we all debate about constantly and argue about, whether it's in guild chat, Discord chat, or in VCs. I'm going to ask the each of y'all, all of y'all individually, beginning with, we'll start with Dano. Dano, if we had to pick a setup on Alb to run, what should we run?
We're ironing out the comp right now. Yeah,
I want people to be a part of the conversation. I want to hear everyone's opinion. Don't let anyone influence you. We've tested a few things. We have yet to test some things. If you're balancing out success with fun, enjoyment, all that type of stuff, what should we run, Dana? What are we thinking?
I really like the hybrid. We've never done it. I think it works really well. It does a lot of things. You can still kind of Mongo in and a lot of erupt and control. Of course, there's shortcoming on full tank and there's shortcoming on caster for what you can do. But I feel like that's the caveat where you can kind of do a little bit of everything and still be very successful on the 8-man stuff, especially right now. It's just hip tanker nonstop. You see 3 hip tankers and then 1 mid tanker. That's all you see. So it's like, it's kind of hard. And then as soon as Koth ends, you have 34 mids and 24 hibs chasing you. So it's like,
very true.
It's kind of rough. You need something a little bit more.
When you say Alb hybrid, are you referring to like, so your core is minstrel, sorc, double cleric, right? So they're in there.
But yeah, like arms, pally, third. So sorc, arms, did you say sorc?
So sorc, double cleric. You could sub a cleric for a friar. You know, that's debatable between the two healers. And then a minstrel. So you have those 4. And then your official, what makes it a hybrid, is you're going to have pally, arms, and then a thurg in there.
Thurgus for rups allows the tanks to get in there and stay in there. And then I seen a couple. I seen one with a heretic, one with a cab. The cab had more blap. There was one that had an extra tank, but it kind of lost the hybrid flavor. I feel like kind of the arms and the pally kind of rip.
So
I don't know
pally,
with the merc, what
the pally, minstrel, and arms are up front, and then you could substitute the thurg with a heretic or a cab, is what you're saying, right?
I would definitely keep a thurg, but then that other, isn't there still one more slot?
No, that's 8.
So, okay, then that's it right there.
Okay.
I don't know with the merc with the fangs though. That's kind of that's really good too. So let's have to see how that pans out.
If you put a merc in, do you sub them out for the paladin?
No, I think the pally has to be there for sure.
100%
pally. Said,
or when you
said
collapse on a target.
Sorc?
He said sorc, minstrel, cleric.
Yeah, so that's your 4.
And he said pally, third, arms. There's still one. Oh, there's still one more.
Yeah, so that last slot, I've seen multiple things, but I would like to see maybe a merc in there, see if that would work. That's more of a straight up tanker with a caster, but still, I don't know, Cabalus for a little bit more blap or...
I mean, yeah.
I don't really know that 8th spot.
Put the merc in there, and that's... more, but I guess it's kind of hybrid, but
it's more just like a tank, yeah.
So you could lean
pure reps, and yeah. At that point, so is the sorc.
Those aggressive hybrids on Albert are hard to stop. It's just their W and forward, their spread. It's crazy.
I would love to see minstrel, arms, pally, merc up front. So those 4, and then in the back you have your 2 healers, and then thurg, and probably what would sorc. Make the most sense would be a sorc. Yeah, for the CC.
You still might have enough rope with the sorc and the
that'd be a lot of minstrel. Pressure. You just don't. I guess there's no burst there. Is what the one thing you're missing is burst. Because you're gonna have the thurg locking people down. You got 4 people up front locking people down that could then collapse on a target to kill it.
Yeah, once those 3 tanks collapse, though, they get enough roped out, and then when they call the collapse target with the celerity, it's gonna rip it apart.
All right. Negative. Same question. What do you think we should run?
Sorc, cleric, friar, minstrel. So your base 4.
Yep.
Obviously the friar instead of the cleric. Wizard, thurg, sorc, arms would be.
So our
my ideal place to hop.
So our wizard setup essentially, the one that we are trying to kind of aim towards right now.
Thurg and heretics debatable. I think thurg if you're going to fight more organized groups. Obviously, it's probably a little better for the interrupts and stuff like that, PBT, whatever. But
okay,
that comp rips, man.
I think we saw a dose of its potential today, for sure, with just with the wizard. I think I can't wait to have all eight of us with that setup because I think we have all of those pieces and all the players to play those pieces. I'm looking forward to, you know, how it turns out. Illusive, what would you do, brother?
We're sticking to Alb, you said?
Yeah. We're Albs.
I suppose.
Do you agree more?
The main four.
Okay, go ahead.
The main four. So I would swap the arms for a Merc.
So no heavy at all?
Pally. Merc Pally instead of arms Pally.
Okay.
And then any two casters, really. Any casters that like debuff for each other. It wouldn't really matter.
What's your thought process on dropping the arms for the Merc?
Because you could just have the Pally be the tanky one with his chance, and then the Merc has diseases on targets, charge, like charge is big in a fight. Even if it's just one charge, like you get somebody just in there, can't do nothing about him besides kill him.
Okay. Know? And then just some bursty train of some nature in the back with the other two.
Yeah, it could be anything really, but wizard probably like the highest damage dealt.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah, third wizard, third, yeah, whatever.
So a second Sork and a wizard, or you could do a cab with something assisting it. Second Sork and a cab if you want to do a body train. Okay.
Something like that. I agree.
All right. Pepper, what do you think, brother?
I'm with Negative. I like the wizard setup.
Mm-hmm.
I think we talk about how effective setups are in eight mans, and like I don't really think about that too. Like I want to be able to have some success, right? Like I think the wizard setup might struggle with all the tanks we're fighting, but I don't really care. Like we'll still have some good success in an eight man, but I think it's really good when we're picking at the Zerg and doing that kind of stuff. So like there's a balance that I want there, and I think the wizard is big for that.
One of our thoughts to just kind of look at that particular point, we thought the wizard would be stronger with the tanks for the twiff that you can throw out, the fact that when a wizard has a debuff with bolts, you can kill anything including a heavy tank pretty quickly. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And then the Realm Rank 5 makes them, you know, pretty stout if they've got, like, tanks all over them and stuff.
Well, but, and I like the, obviously, I've been loving my Friar. So yeah. You add the Friar in there with ST, and mm-hmm. I like that. And then it helps get people off you, and when we're hitting Zergs, having ST and Twiff is nice.
Yep.
Cotton, what are you thinking, man?
Yeah, I've actually been thinking about this a lot lately. Obviously, like, I haven't been around very much to see the groups and stuff. But I see what we keep fighting. And it's going to, I keep talking about it. It's going to change as our arc gets higher.
Yeah.
And as pop changes a little bit, while it's been crazy right now, we know it's not going to stay like this for a long time, right? Yeah. Or it will stay like this for a long time, hopefully, but it's not going to stay like it for the whole season. And I think that it's two different groups are going to shine really well for both of those periods. Personally, I don't necessarily have a comp in mind, but I am body train bias. I love it. If we are running body train, personally, I would love to see two clerics instead of cleric friar. However, after today, I was really vibing with cleric friar. Yeah. Obviously, I'm starting with support because that's
and I wasn't even healing.
I just like that the resists were noticeable, but also when I think about it and having the ST available, I think it's huge. We could literally use the ST to run to, and
yeah. I like how you were vibing with the Friar when you were running with a Friar who had reflex attack 3 and long limb 1.
Right.
I saw it made me start thinking. That's all I'm saying. Seeing the resist. Yeah, yeah. It got me.
Well, I saved you at one point with Hand of God, so that was
did.
Yeah, I would like to see that more, just to keep testing its, you know, potential and how effective it can be.
I have to say, Hand of God. I came into season one saying Hand of God was going to be my play, and I was going to use it, and it was going to be amazing, and I was loving it. And they took it away from my class and gave it to the Friar. And everyone knows I'm not going to play Friar if Pepper's on a Friar. Like, one of us has to be a cleric, right?
Yeah.
But I have been for that. I personally would love to see another tank up front. So the hybrid setup, Personally, I think two heavies being two armsmen would be fucking delicious because they can, they're just so hard to kill. Paladins are obviously going to be good, and they'll also help that armsman when they come together and collapse on a target. But I don't think the paladin is as survivable as the armsman. And the arms, I mean, you can go crazy. And then if you have two armsmen RR5s ready on the back burner, like that's
to help with the tanks.
That's pretty incredible for
two furies, two bolsters. There's a lot to argue there.
I think what we all agreed on is that the comp or what will be good or what will be fun will change with RR unlock.
Yeah,
like, I agree.
RR unlock and population change. Like people switch to different setups, even
For sure. Or there's just low rum rank. There's no way to get a charge tank off you, so we have to kill it the fastest. What's good for that? A wizard, right?
But
RR7,
it's different.
Based on what we have available and kind of what we've already dipped our toes into, I think our main focus on this getting the wizard incorporated with Street back on MA, I think that was a good idea. And, you know, I saw glimpses of that really being nice today. Negative blowing stuff up and Street calling out targets. That was just back to where we needed to be. I felt that. I'm really interested, the more I think about it, in Pepper switching to Friar. And just going high juve and staying back and just having insane heals with all those resists. Those resists are going to be so helpful to Dano too. And Illusive being up, up front, getting collapsed on when people call targets on them. So I want to try the hybrid like Dano's suggesting.
Yep.
I really want to try that. And that might be something we need to talk about because I think it's worth trying, especially early on. And it's just something we haven't really done yet. So I think that'd be really fun to try. We would just have to decide who's going to play what, who's going to rotate, so on and so forth. But I think that would be a lot of fun to do.
Yeah. I mean, I am like a third string right now, but I will say, talking really publicly about like our setup is just kind of funny because it feels so casual. I love it.
Yeah.
But I want to make a paladin. I would love to make a paladin or an armsman.
Holy cotton, baby.
Holy cotton.
I
mean, not that I'm round enough to be counted off for that stuff.
What before we wrap things up, what was I going to ask? What's everyone thinking about season 2 so far? How are we feeling? A lot of server instability for some people.
It seems really hit or miss what's going on.
As of late.
We have had a little more lately.
As of late.
I don't think it's been too bad, though, in my opinion. Like, not nearly in the realm of unplayable or anything like that. There's just been a couple times where it's like, damn.
Do we think today's issues were more so just overall stress and pop numbers having an effect, or is there some kind of network bug that people are experiencing? Because it does seem to be very selective.
There were a massive amount of people in that area, but it did seem like the West Coast people were struggling more than...
Well, and it was weird. I just relogged and it went away, right? Like, I was having it too. I relogged and it went away. There's still the same amount of people in that area. So I don't know that it... I don't know what it is.
I don't know what it is.
Go ahead, Dana.
I play on a toaster and mine was fine, so I don't know.
Yeah, it's so weird. And I didn't have a single issue all day, whether it was
my internet's not hardwired to my computer. It's the Wi-Fi, so like,
I mean, I have a pretty dope computer, but like, so does Pepper. But Pepper's issues was like updates today, right? Like you had
That was me blue screening. My delay though, I don't know. Like I'm wired in. I have fiber, my internet's great. No other issues there. So, right. But I was having it was literally like a 30-second delay at one point when I would click a spell.
Bishop said he was having like 2-second delay on heals.
And his went
I got a little bit of like shorter delay when we were fighting by that tower. It was happening. Gotcha. So, I don't know.
My IP address is in Indonesia right now. So.
All right. Well,
Starlink.
We are at about an hour and 20 minutes, which is a good podcast time. I think we can wrap it all up. When it comes to the podcast going further, for anyone who gives a flip, we will We're still debating on whether or not we're going to have episodes the next couple of weeks. We're thinking about pre-recording something on Friday, and then having it go live on YouTube Sunday or whenever we can get to it as soon as possible. And then, of course, Spotify and things like that. We are going to be doing some guild showcases. And with that being said, if anyone wants to showcase their guild, just like we do every week, talking about our setup, talking about what we enjoy, anything at all, if you want to showcase your guild, please shoot me or Cotton a DM and talk to us. We are talking to people from Barbie right now who are in our alliance. We're looking to get some of them on soon, which we're looking forward to. The more people we can get on this podcast, the more perspectives we can hear from, and the more awesome conversations we can have. So please, if you want to be a guest or get your guild showcased or anything of that nature, again, reach out to me or Cotton via DMs on Discord. When it comes to the new year, we're probably going to back down from a weekly schedule and lean more so towards a bi-weekly schedule, just so that we all have more time to actually enjoy the game and not necessarily feel the pressure of having to deliver something every single Sunday. I think I'm willing to commit to a bi-weekly, like every other week.
I think so, too.
Yeah, I think that'll be good. And we also don't want to run out of things to talk about either, you know, so we want to keep things fresh. I try to produce the best content that I can, but even I get to a point where I go, all right, well, what do we talk about this week? And, I don't want to have that pressure or that issue. So, Negativ, huge shout out for winning the trivia. Y'all all need to go study Trials of Atlantis more.
Yeah, I got my book. I'm going to go read it.
hardest trivia of my life, dude.
Yeah, well, you're welcome. Negativ, if you are a minstrel that can play from the 20th to the 26th PST. Hey, me and Illusive already exchanged accounts. I will be playing minstrel or able to play minstrel for us through that time. So
I could put out posts like filling temporary Spicy Boy spot. Yeah. We could see how many applications we get.
I mean, that's how everybody got in. You played a temporary spot for a week or so and just stuck around.
It's true.
See if you vibe, baby.
Please, someone take over a minstrel. I'd love to play a DPS class. That'd be fun, too.
Oh, man. All right. For Dano, Illusive, Negativ, first timers here. Thanks for being on. We appreciate y'all showing up.
Thanks, sir. Thanks for having us.
Thank you. Shout out to the Spicy Boys who could not make it tonight. Hopefully,
shout out to Mac in that hot tub.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Drive safe, Zoo.
Pepper, thanks for being a part of it again, buddy. We appreciate you being here as always. And
shout
then
out to ours.
Cotton,
moderator, scorekeeper, you know what I'm saying?
Cotton, my PIC, thank you for being here, sir, as always.
Of course. Thank you for all the work you put into this. This whole episode was Inc. He came up with all the questions. He came up with the formula, and literally I just took a backseat today. I barely did anything, so... Thank you so much, man.
Absolutely.
I'm going to have to go talk about my feelings with you guys after this.
And then
Negativ in particular.
I deleted my cleric, so.
Last but certainly not least, Moxie, thank you for scorekeeping and hanging out with us and being a part of our shenanigans as always. It's very much appreciated. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thanks, Moxie.
Love you, Pepper. Hey, thanks for hanging out with us last night, too. That was
fun.
That's a normal fun night.
Oh man,
that was fun.
Fucking pass.
She loves the RVR with the Spicy Boys, guys. Don't let her, you know, put any negative vibes. Okay, it's great. It's a great time. But anyway, we're gonna wrap it up. My name is Inc.
I'm Cotton,
and this is our podcast. Thank you so very much for taking part of it. Check us out on Cotton's YouTube. Check out the Twitch, the Spotify, all that good stuff. Thank you for being here. Peace out. Take care.
Bye.